wasn't to Nehemiah's biggest weakness. Last week, Jonathan and Chris were talking about doing that big thing for us. We are all needed. And to be at the body of Christ, we all have different gifts and skills. And each of us, whatever role we're fulfilling, all that we're required in the church is important and necessary. So we're going to continue on in the story of Nehemiah. And I wanted to talk today, really, about what happens. It's almost a hard time when we can barely, barely go, but still, the overall gets done. I wonder if you've ever had this experience of doing something like cash revolution. I remember a few years ago when we moved to the we thought before we bought it, we had in the house, we wouldn't need to do much. We arrived, and then of course, the inevitable happened. We thought, we need to do pretty much everything. So we set the walls back up and replastered, sanded the floors, painted, hours stripping paint off the banister. They make this decision that instead of going after the full time, instead there will still be the gap. I think it's so instructive that, and so helpful when we think about what it might be that we have at the moment. When I think about the idea of being a full time, I think of production values. I think of our services having a load of people. I think of, millions of kids and youth work, churches, libraries. And all of them, maybe what we need to do is continue to fill all the gaps, actually to work on the foundation of where we're at, and in time, there's more that we're able to go up to the next level. So what might it be for all our jobs? I'm so keen that we're going to be able to get the coffee going again. So it seems to me that that will work our jobs, not coffee in itself, although it helps to get the coffee to get more alive, but in fact, that sense of hospitality and connection with each other that we've all lost during the pandemic. Having dreams actually enables us to do that. I wonder if you might discuss in your groups where our gaps might be, or what you would like to see as a full height. We don't want to be a unique collaboration. We are shared with the achievement of it, but we still want to recognize that also basics can come to mind, and sometimes it's the foundations that we need to work on. I think small groups are a great foundation of peace as well. And praying and worshipping and doing that work at intercession, looking to see where God is at work, keeping our eyes open, reminded of the inscription above the door in the church of Christ here in the church building. It says, "Do not be expected." Sometimes that's what we've got in to do because we're tired, but sometimes that is also the wisest thing to do. So, how do we keep going when we think that there's a long way to go? So, Nehemiah and the people show us three things that we can keep going with. Number one is faith, number two is energy, and number two is unity. Firstly, they needed a reason for the faith. They started, I think, in all the activity for their faith to begin. Nehemiah said to them, "Remember the Lord who is great and awesome, and fight for your families." Remember the Lord. You know all the way through this passage in Nehemiah. So they can actually work pre-tournament. Remember the Lord and fight. Stand firm and keep living. They needed a reason in their faith so that they could keep going with the work that they've been assigned to do. I wonder how do you keep going in your faith? So often, actually, we just need some words to keep us going. Words are so important, aren't they? And they can really build it up when things are hard. So, we all need to build up our faith. Worship, and recognizing the presence of God, sometimes even just to glory on and keep it going, helps to renew our faith and commitment while we work together. But the Israelites needed a reboot in faith. They needed a reboot in energy. They gathered together. They've done actually something really amazing. And there was so much more built with so many people trying to not be true. It can't be made anyway. But they needed anything again. So they gathered together, they focused on the gaps. And they also grouped together again, a kind of natural grouping, because they worked in families. Now, sometimes the Lord gives us natural families, nuclear families, relations.